Leiden, the Netherlands, 9 o'clock in the evening. Staff at Eurotransplant are in the allocation center, completing the records of the donor procedures that took place earlier that day when a new donor is reported. The allocation center is the link between donors and recipients and is staffed 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Organs from donors can only remain for a brief period outside the human body. When allocating organs, time is therefore an important factor. The report concerns a donor in Hungary. He is a 30-year-old man from whom several organs can be used to improve or even save the lives of others: heart, lungs, liver, pancreas, and kidneys. For the allocation duty officers, this is the go-ahead to start working for several patients who are waiting for an organ. Eurotransplant is an organ exchange organization linking the Netherlands, Belgium, Luxembourg, Germany, Austria, Slovenia, Croatia, and Hungary. Within this geographical area, thousands of people are waiting for an available organ, sometimes for years already. For some, the wait is a matter of life and death. The unique cooperation between the Eurotransplant countries literally saves lives. Through this cooperation, the chance of finding a suitable organ in time is increased significantly. The donor in Hungary has multiple organs available. For staff, it's now a question of following a number of predetermined protocols. First, the report is checked for details such as abnormal blood values, possible viruses, and when the removal of the organs is planned. When all the data is complete, matching can start. Donor organs are allocated to patients on the waiting list based on medical and ethical criteria. The urgency, as well as the expected benefit and success of the transplant, are also included in this deliberation. With every offered organ, the computer system creates a match list of patients who are eligible for it. This match list is compiled from various data, such as blood type, height, age, and the weight of both the donor and potential recipients. Patient selection and placement on the match list is laid down in the stringent rules of the national authorities of the Eurotransplant countries. At the very top of the list are the most urgent patients. This group will have priority in the international exchange of suitable donor organs. This is followed by all the patients in the donor country for whom the organ is suitable. Thereafter, the match list contains the appropriate recipients in the other Eurotransplant countries. Because not every organ is suitable for each patient, it can happen that a patient for one organ is third on the match list, but for a subsequent organ offer, eighth, for example. If there are no recipients for an organ within the Eurotransplant area, the organ is offered to partner organizations in other European countries to prevent an organ being lost. For the allocation duty officer, making a match is ultimately no more than pressing a button. But behind that button are advanced computer systems which are permanently online. Eurotransplant develops and maintains these systems itself. The allocation duty officers allocate the various organs simultaneously. A check is always carried out for patients who require multiple organs. For example, some patients on the waiting list not only need a heart, but also a new kidney.
Good evening, this is Jessica speaking, Eurotransplant.
When allocating organs in the allocation process, it's important that not only the transplant center of patient number one is contacted, but also of number two on the list. If the offer from patient number one cannot be accepted, staff can therefore quickly switch to the center of the next patient on the list to avoid losing valuable time. Allocation staff are the connecting link between donor and recipient. Their role is crucial. They undergo a 6-month training period at Eurotransplant and also take an annual assessment exam. The allocation team staff can always fall back on the expertise of a doctor who is permanently on call and advises the team when necessary. The organs will be removed from a donor in Hungary in 6 hours. The lives of multiple recipients will be improved and in some cases, even be saved. At Eurotransplant, it has now become clear to which patient the organs will be offered, first and second, according to the match list. The allocation duty officer is busy calling the transplant centers that could receive the organs.
Ich rufe an mit einem primäres Herzangebot für Spender 155.
Possible recipients have been found in Hungary itself for the heart, pancreas and liver, and for the lungs in Austria. For the kidneys, the tissue typing must first be carried out on the characteristics of the donor tissue, after which the match can take place. For a kidney transplant, in addition to matching the blood group, a match for other tissue characteristics is also very important. To do this, the donor's tissue characteristics are determined. We call this HLA, human leukocyte antigen. All the potential recipients on the waiting list have already had this done. A match procedure can take place only when the HLA of the donor is known. At 2300 hours, the evening shift in the allocation center has transferred their duties to the night shift. Earlier this evening, the hospitals in Austria and Hungary accepted their offers. In principle, they have had half an hour for this. Within that time period, they had to reach the potential recipient and determine whether they can accept the organ.
So die Entnahme ist jetzt definitiv 33 heute Nacht.
In the meantime, the tissue characteristics of the donor have been determined. Now the kidneys can also be matched. This shows that based on an HLA match, there are potential recipients in Hungary and Germany as the first patients eligible for the kidneys. However, whether one kidney actually remains in Hungary and one actually goes to Germany depends on so-called cross-matching. Cross-matching takes place here. Any member country of Eurotransplant has certified laboratories where, besides HLA typing, a patient's antibodies are determined. The doctors of kidney patients on the waiting list send their patients' blood to all the laboratories in the 8 Eurotransplant countries every 3 months. If a donor kidney becomes available, cells from the donor and blood from the possible recipient can be linked directly to each other or crossed in the laboratory in the donor region. This is called a cross-match. It determines whether the patient has antibodies which will react against the donor kidney. If no reaction occurs, the cross-match is negative and the kidney transplant can be prepared. As the kidney is being transported to the hospital where the recipient is located, a final cross-match takes place to ensure no antibodies are present in the blood that could still reject the kidney. For this later, more extensive cross-match, fresh blood from the recipient is taken. While all of Europe is sleeping, the allocation center is in full swing. At 0100 hours, a new donor report has come in, which an allocation duty officer is about to process. The organs from the donor in Hungary will be removed in about an hour and a half. A surgeon with his team has flown to Hungary for the lungs. They take the lungs in a helicopter back to Austria. The kidney for Germany goes by plane. To keep the communication lines as short as possible, staff in the hospitals of the donor and recipient organize the transportation of the organs. Eurotransplant monitors and supports this when necessary. Eurotransplant was founded in 1967 by the Dutch professor Dr. John van Loo.
Goedemiddag, u spreekt met Ellie van de Vecht van Eurotransplant in Leiden.
Goedemiddag.
Ik heb een nier aan te bieden voor...
Decades of experience have resulted in a knowledge center that's important for transplant medicine. Eurotransplant manages an extensive database of waiting lists, donor data, and the medical records of transplanted patients. As a result, Eurotransplant experts are able to make accurate analyses and reveal trends. The results of these studies are used by expert committees to continuously improve transplant outcomes and the allocation rules. When bringing together expertise, we always have a single major goal in mind. How can we ensure that transplants can be even more successful so that we can improve the quality of life of more and more people? The heart, lungs, liver, pancreas, and kidneys are removed from the donor at the agreed time. Meanwhile, the cross-match for the kidneys has delivered a favorable result. All the organs can now be transported and begin a new life. This case is nearing its end. It will only be closed when Eurotransplant is notified that the transplant has taken place. Tonight, several patients have been saved in Hungary, Austria, and Germany. And that is Eurotransplant's most important goal: rescuing or providing a better quality of life for patients who have sometimes been waiting years for a donor organ. But the allocation duty officers have little time to enjoy this success. They are busy allocating organs from a donor in the Netherlands. And as the morning begins, a new donor report has already appeared on the screen. Eurotransplant, cooperating, saves lives.